Hello friends, today we are going to see superposition theorem. Let us see statement of the superposition theorem. In a linear bilateral network containing more than one source, the resultant current or voltage of any branch is the algebraic sum of the currents or voltages that would be produced by each source acting alone, all other sources being replaced meanwhile by their respective internal resistances. If internal resistance RSE of any voltage source and the internal resistance of RSH of any current source are not given, assume RSE equal to 0 and replace the voltage source by a short circuit, and assume RSH as infinity and replace current source by an open circuit. Now let us see how to apply superposition theorem to find out the current flowing through AB branch of this given network shown in figure A. Now in this network there are two voltage sources V1 and V2. The R1 and R2 are the internal resistances of sources V1 and V2 respectively. Let I1, I2 and I3 are the currents flowing through resistances R1, R2 and R3 respectively. Now let us consider V1 source acting alone. So V2 source must be replaced by its internal resistance R2. It is shown in figure B. Now in this case, I11, I12 and I13 are the three currents flowing through resistances R1, R2 and R3 respectively. So by using suitable network simplification technique, we can easily find out current flowing through branch AB. Now in next case, or in next step, let us consider V2 source acting alone. So replace V1 source by its internal resistance R1. This circuit is shown in figure C. Now in this case, I21, I22 and I23 are the currents flowing through resistances R1, R2 and R3. So by using suitable network simplification technique, we can easily find out current flowing through branch AB. So now we have two currents. In first, when we consider V1 source acting alone, we have current I13 flowing through branch AB. When V2 source acting alone, we have current I23 flowing through branch AB. So according to superposition theorem, total current I3 flowing through branch AB is nothing but the addition of currents I13 and I23. Therefore, total current in branch AB equal to I3 equal to I13 plus I23. Now let us see different steps to apply superposition theorem. Step number 1. Select a single source acting alone. Short the other voltage sources and open the current sources if internal resistances are not known. If internal resistances are known, then replace the voltage source and current source by their internal resistances. Step number 2 is that to find the current flowing through or voltage across required element due to the source under consideration using a suitable network simplification technique. Step number 3 is to repeat the above two steps for all the sources present in the network. And the final step is to find the addition or add the individual effects produced by individual sources to obtain the total current in or voltage across the elements. Now let us see applications and limitations of superposition theorem. The superposition theorem is applicable only to linear bilateral network where all the resistances are linear, that is where all the resistance values are constant irrespective of variation of currents and voltages in magnitude and direction. Thus, the superposition principle is not applicable to the circuit containing non-linear unilateral elements such as diodes, rectifiers, thermistors, etc. This theorem is not applicable for determination of power in any branch because power is a non-linear function. Now, let us find the current flowing through 10 ohm resistance in a given network. Now observe this network carefully. There are two voltage sources, 4 volt and 6 volt, and we have to find out the current flowing through this 10 ohm. Let this branch be AB branch. Now in first step, let us consider 4 volt source acting alone. So short this 6 volt source. Now we get this circuit after this modification. Now here 3 ohm and 10 ohm resistances are in parallel. So find out equivalent resistance, 3 multiplied by 10 divided by 3 plus 10, and add this to 2 ohm, because now this equivalent resistance and this 2 are in series. After that, find out total current in this network, IT. So IT equal to voltage source 4 divided by 2 plus this equivalent resistance 2.308. It is equal to 0.928 ampere. Once we find this total resistance IT, we can easily find out current flowing through AB branch, that is through 10 ohm. Let that current be I dash AB. So I dash AB equal to, by current division method, IT, that is total current, multiplied by opposite branch resistance, that is 3 ohm, divided by addition 3 plus 10. So it is equal to 0.214 ampere. Now in next step, let us consider 6 volt acting alone in the network and short this 4 volt. So circuit becomes like this. Let now current flowing through this 10 ohm resistance be I dash EB. So now in this case, let us find out total current produced by the 6 volt. Let that current be IT. Now this 2 ohm and this 10 ohm are in parallel. To find out equivalent resistance, add this equivalent resistance with 3 ohm, because now this is in series. So total current IT, it is equal to 6 volt divided by 3 plus this equivalent resistance 1.667. We get total current IT equal to 1.286 ampere. Now let current flowing through this 10 ohm resistance be I double dash B. So I double dash B equal to IT multiplied by opposite branch resistance 2 divided by 2 plus 10. Okay, so we are going to find this I double dash AB current by using current division method, and we get answer equal to 0.214 ampere. So now last step is to find the total current flowing through 10 ohm resistance. It is nothing but the addition of I dash AB and I double dash AB. I dash AB is the current when 4 volt source acting alone, and I double dash AB is the current when 6 volt source acting alone. So it is equal to 0.214 plus 0.214, it is equal to 0.428 ampere. That's all for today's.